Ransomware payments broke the $1 billion mark in 2023. This is a week in security by ESET. Keep listening to find out more. Ransomware payments in 2023 topped $1.1 billion. That's according to the blockchain company Chainalysis, who diligently track payments being paid due to ransomware demands. The number is close to double that of 2022, but 2022 appears to have been an anomaly as it showed a decline of about $416 million on 2021, and that's when the number stood at a massive $983 million. The financially astute among you will realise this is not actually an increase between 2021 and 2023. It's just keeping pace with inflation. I assume ransomware criminals suffer from the same cost of living increases that we all do. Cyber insurance premiums for 2023, according to Marsh Risk Management Consultancy, were flat. But this is on the back of a peak 110% increase in 2022 and a similar peak in 2021. All very much above the rate of inflation and represent the industry trying to claw back losses from claims in 2020 and 2021. The cyber insurance industry is growing. Now, according to Fitch Ratings, it grew to $5.1 billion in 2023, an increase of 62%. And if, as according to Marsh, the premium growth was flat, then this increase shows more new policies being established as companies scramble to insure against that inevitable cyber incident. Some believe the increase in the ransomware numbers is based on better targeting by cyber criminals. And while this may be true in part, there is likely a close relationship to companies being insured against a cyber incident, and thus the insurer paying a demand when needed. But paying a ransomware demand should be a last option on the list. Realistically, only an option when there is a risk to life or something similar. Paying because it's an easy option and the least disruptive to a business is not a reason to pay, either directly by a company or via their insurer. Something needs to change. It's clear that bringing cyber criminals to justice is unlikely due to the jurisdiction and political influences. We cannot continue to stand by while organised crime extorts money from companies. And remember, at the end of this, it's you and me that are paying as the consumers of those businesses. For more cybersecurity news, check out WeLiveSecurity.com. Stay safe, stay healthy, and be sure to catch our future videos.